Hello friends, I'm Rahul Kumar, and in this video I will explain you how to create a bracket in Catia v5 with the help of all this command. As you can see in this image here, in this PDF here, this image here. So in this video I will explain you how to create this image, this part in Catia v5 with the help of all these tools like sketching pad, 3-point arc, edge fillet, mirror, cube time, constraint and profile. And in the last I will explain you how to color it's all different part with different colors. So start this. So before I start, I will like to explain you that in this video how I will create this image in Catia v5. To start in this video or to create this image, first I have to create this part, or either you can start from here or from here, but I will start from here because it will help me to create this upper part. So I will first create this part, later on I will create this upper part, and then after that I will create this circle cylinder here, and then this part and this two hole. So start this. So friend, it open now. I will start here. And I will select the budget plane here. So friend, in the image you can see this part, its length is a total length inside 80 and in this side also 80. So I will first create a square or you can create a rectangle here of the length 80. So I will create a rectangle here, or either you can select from here or you can click on this arrow sign, and from here you can select this part. In this, if you click in this and if you click on the center point, then it will form the same length of rectangle here, and in this you do not have to do again symmetry line. So in this, and after that you have to select this constraint here and you have to select its length. So its length is 80 and here also its length is 80. So friend, it's form here, and now I will pad it. To pad, I will select this pad tool, and as you can see in this figure, its total thickness is you can take 12 mm. Here it given here 12 is there, so I will put here 12 mm, and then okay. So friend, it formed here. And to give its edge, I will click here in this one setting option, and I will click on this arrow sign here, and after that I will select this second option, its name is setting with edge, and after doing that you can see it showing all these edges here. Now I will form the second part, this upper part here. To form this upper part, we have to keep two three things in the mind. The first thing is that this circle radius here, you can see small radius is here, its radius is 15, and from this point to this point its length is 65, and again from this upper part its radius is 30. So if we join all this 65 and this radius, then from this point to this total top edge point it will length as 95 mm. So and after that here in this top part, it's not a simple length here. In this we have to form a circle type. So we will first and we also have to see its width here. So you can see its radius here is 30. So from this center point to this side is 30, and the same is here. So total thickness is 60 mm. So we will form it here. So here to create the image, I will select this part here. And friend, if while doing this stitching part and you want this whole part in this way and it's not came and it came in this vertical way, then in this case you have one option here. In this case you have to select here. After that you have to click in this arrow sign and you have to select this other option, second option it is. And in that you have to, there you can do reverse H, reverse V or sweep. So I will do sweep and then OK. And friend, you can see it came in this horizontal way. So now it's easy to design the sketch here in this part. So now I will design this second part here. And I will first design this this length, and then after that I will design this radius here. And now from here to here its length is, in this figure you can see from this point to this point its length is 65. So I will give it as is 65 here. And these two lines it should be symmetry to this axis. So I will select this constraint and I will select these two line and I will do arrow symmetry line and I will select this axis here. Now it formed here. Now it's time to design this this part. So to design it, for that I have to select a 3-point arc here. Sorry, a 3-point arc, sorry. So here it is, a 3-point arc here. And now I will select, so before that I will highlight this edge here, and to highlight this edge I have to select that option is not, yeah, it's here. I have to click on project 3D element and I will click on this and I will select this edge. So you can see it highlighted here, and now I will select this 3-point arc. Now I will first select this point and now this point and then this point. So and now you can see in the image its radius is 15. So now I will select this constraint and I will select this curve here. Sorry. So friend, you can see its radius is 16. I have to give it 15. So it formed here, you can see. And in the same way I have to create in this part. And now I do not have to do this step again. Now to create this same part on the opposite side, I will select this mirror option and I will select this axis here, or you have to select first this curve here and then this axis. So you can see it formed here now. And now it's time to give its thickness here, its length here. So now I will select this constraint and I will give it. As you can know in this figure, its total width is 60. So I will give it as a 60. And friend, and now this second part is formed here. As you can see in the image, this second half part is formed here. Now it's time to form this upper part. So to form this upper part, first I have to create this half circle here. So now I will select this circle here and I will click in this point. As you can see, it came in this axis here. and it also came in this line here. So, and now it's showing a 0. You can see on the top here it's showing as a 0. So it's a point which we want. So I will click on this and I will form a circle here, and you can see in the figure its radius is 30 here. So it's full is, so its full diameter is 60 here. So I will first I form this circle here, and now it's time to give its value. Its value is 60. So it formed now, and now it's time to trim this other part. So, and now to remove it, I will select a cube trim, and I will select this other part, and now you can see it formed here. So friend, it almost done here, this second part, and now it's time to friend, before doing this padding part, I will remove this line here. So again I have to do this constraint here. Yeah, now I will add it. I will do it on the reverse way, and now okay. So friend, you can see it formed here. This second part is also formed here, and now it's time to form this cylindrical part. And here you can see this cylindrical part is on the middle point of this axis, and the outer cylindrical radius is 20, and the inner one have the value as 25. So I will create this part one here, and to create this part I have to select this part here, and I will select this sketching part. Yeah, and friend, you can see its middle point, this axis is from this point to this point, also have the length of 65. So here also in this sketching part also, from this line to this edge to this center point, it should also have the length of 65. So friend, it formed here. Now it's time to exit here, and now I will add it. Here you can see in the image its total height is, its total height, it's here, yeah, its total height is 30 mm. So total height is, so friend, it this third part is also done here, and now it's time to form this fourth part. So to form its fourth part, I have to select one this center axis here. As you can see here in the sketching part, in this part I have to select this center sketch. So due to that only I can form here this fourth part here. So to create this fourth part, I have to select this center axis, I mean this z-axis plane here, and after that I have to select this sketching part. And friend, you can see it came in the center here also in the image. This fourth part is on the center axis here, center plane here. So to create also here, I have to select this center plane, and now it's time to create it. And you can see in this figure here, from this edge to this outer edge of this cylindrical part, from here to here this length we have to check it out. So as you can see, its total length from here to here is 65, and the outer cylindrical part have the radius of 20 mm. So If I reduce 65 to 20, so it's from this edge to this point, it have the length of 45, and here the upper edge have the radius of 50, as you can see here. So I will form it here now. And friend, it's time to make all this line attached with all these edges here. So so friend, here this three part is over here. And now it's time to form this arc part here, and to create this arc part, I will select again a 3-point arc here, and I will select this first point here, this second point here, and this third point here. And now it's time to give its value, its radius here, and the image, you can see its value as a 50 mm. So here also I have to give it as a 50 mm. So friend, it formed here, and now it's time to pad it. So friend, to pad it in the image, you can see it's along this center plane, this fourth part is almost equal to these two sides. So in the same way, to pad it during the adding part, here some mistake is there. I have to check it. Where is the mistake? Yeah, here is a mistake. You can see this black point is here. So again, I have to correct it. So these two point is not connected here. So I have to make it coincidence. So now it's formed here. Yeah, and now yeah, in this time, first time, you can see in this axis here, in this image, you can see its total of thickness is 10. So here also I have to pad it as a 10 mm, 5 mm to this part, and 5 mm to this part. So in this part, I have to give this value as 5, and in the reverse side also, or you can select from here more, and on the other side also, you have to give add as a 5. And now you have to select this image here, this sketching part here, and now you can see it formed here, and now you have to click on review and then okay.